You know, said the elk, I've seen many men try to achieve this impossible climb. So many have fallen, so many were lost, and have left us before it was time. All the villagers warn of its perils and traps, of the snowfalls and blizzards and rocks that collapse. It's almost as if you were chosen, perhaps, to conquer Forget-Me-Not Mountain. And Peter John Cade looked below at the clouds, which were normally part of the sky, and he realized then just how far he had climbed. It was hard to imagine how high, where the mists gathered thick and the high winds blew shrill, where the earth lay below you so silent and still, and there never could be a more breathtaking thrill than the view from Forget-Me-Not Mountain. The elk stroked his antler and gave a broad smile and said, Well then, young man, here you are, and I think you deserve this reward that I've kept in this crystalline conical jar. I've been waiting to give it for many long years to a man such as you, with so few doubts and fears. So we'll have one more drink, Peter. Well done, and cheers, said the elk of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. In the conical jar was a heart made of gold, which glistened so brightly within. And Peter thought, how would one get the thing out? And, moreover, how did it go in? Ah, I know what you're thinking, the elk said at last. You can't get it out. I'm afraid it's stuck fast. And you can't take it with you. Its worth is too vast, said the elk of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. If I can't get it out, and I can't take it home, said young Peter, that's most contradictory. For I have done something that no man has done, and this would be proof of my victory. My good friends and neighbours might never believe what I have accomplished and sought to achieve. It's a token I feel I deserve to receive, having conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. The mysterious elk gave a sad, rueful smile and said, Peter, I fear you are right. The problem you pose, you have answered yourself. The reward for your conquest seems slight. Dear me, human beings think curious things, and so few understand that success often brings rewards as elusive as butterflies' wings, said the elk of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Yet, is it not beautiful? Added the elk. But allow me to guess, if you will, what fate may await you upon your return to your home at the foot of this hill. Though you're known to be honest, your tale, when it's heard, could be thought of by most to be fairly absurd. For no one came with you. They've only your word that you've climbed up Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Some people do find it much simpler, you know, to appreciate failure and weakness. They say you're only human, yet are often bemused when confronted with human uniqueness. No, you've nothing to show to confirm what you've done, though indeed it's the finest feat under the sun. And you can't even take home the prize that you've won, though you've conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. For where would you say you'd collected it from, when someone might ask you who gave it? They'd say you were dreaming, demented or mad, so it's better all round if I save it. You'll just feel aggrieved if they're doubtful of you, and you can't really tell them, whatever you do, that you met a big elk, in Bermuda shorts too, at the peak of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. And what would you need with a trophy, indeed? You'd just stick it up on a shelf and show it to visitors, neighbours and friends to make a big show of yourself. Beware that your fortunes can quickly reverse, for the gifts of a hero can turn to a curse when people might goad you to do something worse than climb up Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Oh, I've heard quite enough, cried young Peter John Cade, you pompous and talkative elk. What I have accomplished, I've done by myself, and I didn't ask you for your help. You award me a prize I'm forbidden to own. I can't even touch it. I can't take it home. I'd feel less confused if you'd left me alone, by myself, on Forget-Me-Not Mountain. And now you are angry, I see, said the elk, with a sorrowful look in his eyes. I've had no one to talk to for many long years. To have prattled so much was unwise. There are some things that people should not know about, lest you give them the chance to mistrust and to doubt. There'd be much to regret if it ever gets out that you've conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. But surely my conquest, said Peter John Cade, will set an example to others. I have forged a new pathway for climbers to tread, to inspire and give hope to my brothers. To tell of my triumph is something I owe, to allay all the fears of the townsfolk below, for those fears all stem from the little we know of the mighty Forget-Me-Not Mountain. We have much in common, my friend, said the elk, though we meet for the very first time. For both you and I are the only two fellows to conquer this treacherous climb. A long time ago, I set out, just like you, with a faith in my heart and a dream to pursue, and I swore to myself that whatever I do, I would conquer Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Oh, it took me, I must admit, several attempts. With each failure, more stubborn I grew. I remember the feeling so vividly when I beheld this incredible view. I stood all alone on the height of this tor, and I felt like no elk has felt ever before. But on turning around, what do you think I saw? Here alone on Forget-Me-Not Mountain. It dazzled and glistened and shone like the sun. I could hardly believe my own eyes. I felt as if dear God himself had bequeathed such a rich and desirable prize. You must understand, as I'm quite sure you will, that the feeling of triumph, of victory, the thrill made me think with such arrogance, pride and strong will, having conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Yes, Peter, my boy, it was this heart I saw, and I reached out to claim it as mine. I knew in my soul it was waiting for me in this conical jar, crystalline. I tried to dislodge it, with no luck, alas. I shook it and threw it down hard on the grass, but nothing on earth seemed to shatter the glass of the heart of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. So I took heart and jar as I made my descent, whilst a merciless mountain storm grew. I detected the presence of evil around, as a blizzard like thunderbolts blew. And my lonely descent was much harder, it seemed, than the journey towards the high summit had been. But I held the heart tight as the prize of my dream that came true on Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Well, I couldn't believe it. I twice lost my way when the route that I took was the same. It took several days more to complete my descent, a riddle I couldn't explain. But I paid little heed as I saw the huge crowd all waving and clapping and shouting aloud, and I must confess, Peter, I truly felt proud having conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. I held up the heart in the crystalline jar, crying, "See, my good friends, what I've won, a reward from the god of the mountain himself for the challenge I've now overcome." It took pride of place on the shelf on my wall, and many admirers would frequently call, for they'd never seen anything like it at all, this heart of Forget-Me-Not Mountain. Oh, they made me a hero. A statue was built with a flattering inlaid inscription. I was then made a freeman of Switzerland too, with privilege of every description. I was made a celebrity, worshipped by all, and wherever I went, I paid nothing at all. I was honoured each year at the Mountaineer's Ball for climbing Forget-Me-Not Mountain. I'm afraid that such glory went straight to my head, and I noticed a change in my life. To my son, I was less of a father, it seemed, less a husband, indeed, to my wife. Though I'd gone where no other brave mortal had trod, my family's attitude to me seemed odd, and I felt ill at ease at being loved like a god, having conquered Forget-Me-Not Mountain. And my worries weren't groundless, I shudder to say, for in truth, there was much worse to be. The winters grew colder, the skies darker too, and the mountain looked frightening to me, as if it had eyes and a mind of its own, for to look at it chilled me right through to the bone, and the nightmares I had were the worst I had known of the eerie Forget-Me-Not Mountain. There were some in the village quite jealous of me who had given the mountain a try. If that silly elk can climb up it, they said, then I'm sure as can be, so can I. And bold mountaineers came from Switzerland wide to try what no other man living had tried, and were lost in the mists of the dark mountainside of mighty Forget-Me-Not Mountain.